Tonight, we begin by looking back. We look back down the ancient path that God Himself has carved into history. This path weaves itself through the history of humanity to the birth of God's own Son, Jesus Christ. To begin our worship, we will hear from the book of Isaiah, the royal prophet. Sometimes, the book of Isaiah in the Old Testament has been called the fifth gospel, because of all it proclaims about Jesus, the Messiah who has come to save us. Even the name Isaiah points to God's grace because it means the Lord saves. Isaiah's prophecy comes 700 years before the birth of Jesus in Bethlehem. It happens during the expansion of the Assyrian Empire and the decline of Israel. Isaiah foretells the demise of Judah and predicts the restoration and return of God's people from captivity. Isaiah carries the major theme of a highway for the return of the exiles throughout this book of the Bible. The prophecy speaks of peace and safety to mark the new messianic age with a king who is a descendant of David. This king Isaiah tells us about is Jesus. So speak, Isaiah, prophet of Judah. Can you tell of the one, this king, who is going to come?
Nevertheless, there will be no more gloom for those who were in distress.
In the past, he humbled the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali.
But in the future, he will honor Galilee of the nations by the way of the sea beyond the Jordan.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light.
On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned.
They have seen a great light.
You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy.
They rejoice.
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 Before you as people rejoice at the harvest.
For to us a child is born.
To us a son is given.
And the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father.
Prince of Peace.
Prince of Peace.
They're talking about Jesus.
Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom,
establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness.
From that time on and forever,
the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.